वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सेकंड ईयर फिजिक्स. सी इन द प्रीवियस क्लास एक्चुअली वी स्टार्टेड ए इंडक्शन. सी इन दिस इंडक्शन देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ इंडक्शंस आर देयर. वन वी कैन सी सेल्फ इंडक्शन एंड वन मोर वी कैन सी म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. सेल्फ एंड म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन दैट आई वॉन्ट टू से अबाउट ए सेल्फ इंडक्शन. सर वॉट विल बी द सेल्फ इंडक्शन एंड वॉट इज द difference is there between the self and mutual induction. I'll tell you. Self, say for a self there will be a symbol, we can say like this. It is like a coil, like a resistor only, which always opposes. Self inductor is, now you connect a one self inductor, that is the induction is connected to the EMF of a battery. Concentrate what I am saying now, the positive and negative, it is an inductor and the self inductor. No, let us will see. When there is a current flows, that means when there is a constant current flow through the inductor, constant I am saying. So is there any change in flux is linked with this coil? No, because when there is a current flows constant, then there will be flux is constant. Nothing but a what? If there is a change in flux is there, therefore the coil is linked with the change in flux, there it is to be EMF is induces. The EMF is always opposes the changes. That mean here, according to the Lenz's law, EMF is always opposes changes caused by it. That mean here, now I am saying, if the current is increased from zero to maximum, you say zero to maximum is current is induced. Sorry, I mean to say current is sending into the coil, that is current is changing from zero to maximum, there is a current flows through the coil in a given inductor. Therefore, when there is a current is changes, then it is to be flux changes is linked with this coil. In a self it is, because battery connected and the battery is connected to the inductor, then there is a current is flows from zero to maximum, there is a current is changing, so that when there is a current changes, the current is changing, current is produces the magnetic flux. That flux is linked with this inductor. I mean to say, this flux is linked with the inductor, so that that inductor is produces the EMF. That EMF is it is always opposes the changes caused by it, that is we can call as the back of EMF. Because why back of EMF, sir? Because the current is changing from zero to maximum, therefore there will be a flux is changes, that flux is linked with the coil and the flux is flows through the inductor, there it is to be EMF is induces, that EMF is back of EMF, because which opposes the changes. EMF is opposes the changes. This process is nothing but we can call as the self inductor, because it is a self. In a self only it is happens. Self it is, because there is no other coil. The coil is connected in the same circuit. In that same circuit, there is a change in flux is linked. So that because of that, there is a flux changes, that is EMF is induces, there will be a back of EMF we can call. This is about a first case. Now I want to say second case. Suppose you go for like this. See, there is a coil is connected. Again, same situation I am giving now. See, there is a current is changed from zero to maximum. Now what I am doing now, current is from maximum to zero. Now you bring like this, from maximum to zero. So current is reduced from maximum to zero, that is maximum to zero you come, there will be a current is reduced, right? Again, when there is a current reduces, there also what happens, there is a change in flux is induces, the flux is decreases. In this case flux is increases, and in this case flux is decreases, whatever may be, either increased or a decreased. In the both the situation, what will happen? There it is to be EMF is induces. That mean here the flux is glows like this. Then there will be a forward EMF is induces, because the EMF is induces, that is we can say forward EMF, which opposes the change in flux. In this case also, what is happening here? The back of EMF, what is actually doing? That is opposing the changing flux. The flux is, which is to be, we can call as here it is, we can say back of EMF, because it is opposing the increase in the flux. And in this case what happened, there will be a decreasing flux, again it is opposing the decreasing flux. Which one is opposing? The EMF is opposing, because EMF is only caused by the change in flux only. Again, the EMF is what it is doing? Changes opposes. Changes always opposes the EMF. The phenomena we can call as a self-induction. One case is back of EMF, one case is forward EMF. In the both the situation, the EMF is opposing the change in flux. One is increasing flux, one more is a decreasing flux. See, because of increasing flux only, EMF is induced, and because of the decreasing flux only, EMF is induced. But in the both the situation, this forward EMF is always, write as forward EMF is greater than back of EMF. This is a very, very important. Clear? One is forward EMF is induced. One more is, we can say, backward EMF is induced, or back of EMF is induces. So this phenomena we can call as the self-induction, because of the change in current is through the coil is flows. So change in current flows through the coil, there it is to be flux induces. The flux is, because of the change in flux, EMF is induces. That EMF always opposes the, like this. So this is about a self-induction. Now come to the point is, now we need to find a coefficient of self-induction. Sir, what is coefficient of self-induction? Let us, side reading is coefficient of self-induction. Here you write, coefficient of self-induction is nothing but what happens. Here it is, actually there will be a flux is directly proportional to, we can say, current, because current is always changes, therefore there is a flux is induces. Then we can write as to be like this, or which contains a n number turns, no? Yes, we can say like this. So n phi is equal to li. Sir, what is l? L is nothing but we can call as coefficient of self-induction. Clear? Or from here also we can write is equal to li also, no problem. Therefore l is equal to n phi by I. This is the coefficient of self-induction. So when there is a current is I directly, flux directly proportional to current flows through the inductor. Now in terms of EMF, we need to say, in terms of EMF, how we can say EMF? According to the Faraday's second law, we know that is EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt, right? It is E is equal to minus here d phi by dt, we can say. So that here E is equal to minus d by dt of, what will be the phi you say? It is contains a n number terms, so that you say li it is. So E is equal to L into di by dt. This is the EMF induced in the coil. L is nothing but a coefficient of inductance or inductor. Di by dt is nothing but the current changes with respect to time. Di by dt is nothing but the rate of change of current. So n is nothing but a number of turns. So E is equal to, if I take a one turn, L minus L. Sir, why minus? See, this minus indicates this EMF is opposing the change in current. This negative sign indicates that the change in current, it is opposing the change in current. Which one is opposing? The EMF is opposing the change in current. So like it is, we can call as a self-inductance, and L is equal to N pi by I, or E is equal to minus L di by dt, like this. So this is related to what we can say about a self-induction. That is to be, we can say E is equal to minus L di by dt also, we can say. Clear? Now come to the point is, suppose you want to write a capital L is equal to E by minus di by dt, we can. Of course, this is about it like this. EMF in the sense is, we know dimensional formula also, as same as the inductance only, units and dimensions are as same as, that is, we can say MKS or SI system is Henry, it is HERNY, and dimensional formula we know, that is as same as ML square T power minus 2 I power minus 2, and it is also scalar, it is a scalar. Clear it is? Like we can take, and here sometimes we may get like this milli henries, 10 power minus 3 henry. Sometimes he may ask you micro henries, that is 10 power minus 6. Sometimes he may ask you like a mega henries, that is 10 power 6. So these are the requirement in the next coming classes, right? So you remember these all, which are very very important related to. Sir, what is one Henry? Yes, of course you want to write one Henry also. H is equal to 1 volt by, right? It is ampere per current, right? We can say ampere per current. I mean, sorry, ampere per second. 1 Henry is equal to 1 volt by 1 ampere per second. So which we can take as the self induction and coefficient of self induction related to be like this. Is it okay now? So let us. Now we have other also. See, self induction in case of a circular coil, what will happen? Yes, a side heading as. Right, self induction. In case of circular coil, suppose if I take a circular coil, what will happen? The self induction. Suppose we know if the coil is contains, if a circular coil, if there is a current is flows through the circular coil, therefore the coil, in a coil there will be a current is changes, therefore the change in current is produces the magnetic induction at the center of the circular coil because of the change in current. So that we know according to the Biot Savart law, B is equal to mu naught ni by we say 2 R. This is from the Biot Savart law because the circular coil carrying a current, but we know there will be a flux is total flux is induces, that is we can say n into BA. Therefore you write this, you write as a small n, then it is n into B will be mu naught ni by 2 R into A. Of course flux is equal to mu naught n square I by 2 R into A. When there is a, in case of a circular coil, that is a flux is equal to mu naught ni mu naught n square I A by 2 R. So suppose we know according to the which one, inductance, we know L is equal to ni, right? I'm sorry to say it is flux is equal to, that is we can say li, it is we can write like this, no, flux is equal to, we can say it is like it is li. So here we know equation 1 and this is equation 2, therefore equal. Now 1 is equal to 2, supposed to equal mu naught n square I by 2 R into A is equal to li. So in case of a circular coil as a self inductor, the coil as a circular coil act as a self inductor, that is we can say n square A by 2 R. This is for circular coil self inductor. A is nothing but, you know, pi R square. So L is equal to mu naught n square pi R square by 2 R. You cancel 1 R. Then in case of a circular coil, mu naught n square pi R by 2. So this is what it is about a self inductance. Sir, what about EMF? Of course you want to find a EMF. E is equal to minus L di by dt. Yes, L you there, you substitute this L directly there, we'll get the, in case of a self in circular coil act like a self inductor, therefore for that L is equal to mu naught n square pi R by 2. Which is, it is like a it is like a self inductance in case of a circular coil. Is it okay now? Now I want to say self inductor in case of a solenoid. Sir, what happens in case of a solenoid? Side heading as self inductor in case of a solenoid, solenoid. This expression you remember, again it is required. See in the next classes. So next one is a solenoid, right? If I take a solenoid, you know solenoid also. So the solenoid is nothing but a, if there is a number of turns are wounded on the solid cylinder, that we can call as a solenoid. So that you take a solenoid which is to be number of turns are wounded like this, like it is like it is self inductance only. When there is a current flows, it is coming out like this. See, we know in case of a solenoid, there will be a formulas are there. In the previous only we finished capital H is equal to Ni. Or you remember in the previous magnetism, in the previous chapter, see I told you this, H is equal to Ni. And here in case of a solenoid, there will be a magnetic induction is equal to B is equal to, we can say, mu naught Ni. So here Ni also we can replace with H. This is in case of a what it is, we can say self inductance, or we can say it is a solenoid, if a self inductance as a solenoid. And here it is contains a number of turns, no? Therefore small n is equal to number of turns per unit length, you say. You write it like this, then we'll see what will happen, what is happening here, right? So that capital N is equal to, we can also write from here, capital N is equal to, we can also write N into L. But we know when there is a current flows through the self inductor or current flows through the solenoid, then there it is to be flux is induces. See, that flux we can write like this. Flux is equal to capital N BA, because which contains a number of turns is capital N. Of course, we know capital B is nothing but a mu naught Ni. Yes, we can write here. So that the flux is equal to capital N into B will be mu naught Ni into A. So capital N is nothing but a, we can also write NL into mu naught Ni A. So here the flux is equal to, we can say, mu naught N square I into A into L. So we can take like this. It is about what it is. We can say flux related, that is mu naught N square A into L it is. Now let according to flux is equal to Li. We say equation 1, it is equation 2. Now we are finding what? Li is equal to, it is mu naught N square I A L. So L is equal to mu naught N square A L. It is what? In case of a solenoid it is. So we know N also we know, that is we can write as capital N by L. So that which is mu naught N square L square into A L. So you cancel L. In case of a solenoid, mu naught N square A by L. Yes, of course. See, the last one is what it is related to the circular coil. Now this is related to what we can say, it is related to like a solenoid, right? So that mu naught N square by L into A. Look at mu naught N square into A by L. Suppose A you want to write a area. Now here this self inductor in case of a solenoid, it is depends on. So this self inductor in case of a solenoid is depends on, first one we can say geometry of the coil, because in the previous one circular coil, no? So that the circular coil self inductance is different, that formula is different, and this formula is different. That's what we can say, self inductor is depends on, it is depends on geometry, that means shape it is. And second one, it is depends on number of turns, of course. Depends on number of turns, as well as it is depends on length of the solenoid, because it is also L is there. So that it is depends on the length of the solenoid, because how much length we are using the solenoid. And not only that, this is also depends on area of cross section of the solenoid. And this also depends on permeability, that is we can say mu, permittivity, I mean to say permeability, medium, the which the solenoid is allows. And the nature of the material of the core of the solenoid. Nature of the material, which material we are using, of course it is also depends. Nature of the material also it is depends. So that the solenoid related, that is the self induction of a solenoid is, which we can say capital L is equal to mu naught N square A by L. Mu naught N square A by L, it is very very important. And in case of a circular coil, just now we derived the expression, once again I'll tell you, that is a capital L is equal to mu naught N square, like for a circular coil I am writing here, circular coil capital L is equal to mu naught N square pi r by 2. See, you look at both, it is related to the solenoid, it related to the circular coil. Clear? These are the comparison for the both circular coil and as well as the solenoid. Once you go through this, the derivation. Clear? So it is about a what related to the solenoid and as well as the circular coil in case of a self inductors. Is it okay now? So that so once you go through this derivations, actually again we have another one also, that is about a like a energy stored in the self inductor. Actually energy stored in the self inductor, that we have to do the derivation, that we'll see about a energy stored in a self inductor is there. Okay, clear? So that that we'll see in the next class, because on that basis again we have some problems also, so that we'll also will see in the next class. Because before that I'll tell you question number 4, 269 page number. Obtain an expression for the magnetic energy stored in the solenoid in terms of a magnetic field and area length of the solenoid. It is for 4 marks that we have to do, and here as well as the related to this very short answers also given. Define inductance and what are eddy currents also is given. State a Lenz law also. So this already we finished this. Now let us, another one is there. The question related to the self inductor as a magnetic induction, I mean to say that is over, right? Okay, we'll see in the next class, because another question is there. Self inductance, in case of a self inductance, energy stored we need to find. Clear? So thank you very much. We'll see in the next class.